Welcome to this SAP Tech Bite series. This video will be the starting point on your journey to becoming an ABAP developer. In this series, we'll install the IDE, connect an ABAP application server, create your first application, and create a database table. In this video, we'll go through the installation process covering the prereqs, installing the front-end components of ADT, and finally installing the ABAP Git plugin. Let's get started. The first thing we're doing is getting all of our prereqs out of the way. You'll first install SAP GUI for Windows if you're a Windows user, or SAP GUI for Java. I'm going to be clicking on the SAP GUI for Java because I am a Mac user. You click on the link, and it'll ask you to register for full access. You'll put in your registration, and this will allow you to get all of the license that you need for this application. Then you'll go in and click here to start your download. You'll start the download process. Click on the SAP for GUI on your downloading tab. This will take a few minutes, so just grab some coffee and come back, and then you'll start the installation process of that. Now that you have installed SAP GUI onto your computer, we will now register with Docker Hub. And this is quite simple. You'll just need to enter a Docker ID, your email, and password. And this will allow us to install Docker Hub for your desktop. If you're a Mac user, you will click on Docker Desktop for Mac. And if you're a Windows user, you will install the Windows version of Docker. Once you have this installed onto your desktop, you would then go in and get the free trial for the SAP ABAP Platform Developer Edition. And all you have to do is just log in to access the content, where you'll be able to install it freely and easily. Now that we installed all the prereqs that's needed for the ABAP development tool, we'll now get started on installing the front-end component of ADT. First, we'll have to install Eclipse onto our desktop. To do so, you'll click Download on the link. We'll now launch your workspace. We'll click on Launch. Then we'll install the new software onto Eclipse. By doing so, you'll click on Help. Install new software. Then you will install the latest ADT URL, which can be found on developers.sap tutorials. Paste it right onto Work With. Select the ABAP development tools. Click Next. And this should take a while for the software to be installed. You'll then review all the items that's been installed. And as you can see, we have all of the softwares. Click Finish. We will now then go and click on Windows, Perspective. Then you'll click on Open Perspectives and Others. This will switch to the ABAP perspective. And you will just click ABAP, open, and then you can be able to check your results. You can see everything has been installed. And that is how you install ABAP onto your system. The second step to this video is to install ABAP Git plugin. To do so, you will need to transfer your ABAP development objects from on-prem to SAP BTP. Let's get started. First, you will click Open Eclipse, select Help, click Install New Software, just like how we did before. Then we will enter the ABAP Git URL, copy, paste it onto Work With, select, press Next, review the item to be installed, click next, then review the license and accept before the software can be installed, click finished. It is still installing the software, so we'll just give it a few minutes. Now, click restart now. And now, ABAP Git for ADT is installed and ready to use for the cloud.
This wraps up the installation and download process of ABAP. This was the first video of the series. In the next video, we'll create our first ABAP project. See you in the next video.